You've probably noticed by now that I love DaVinci Resolve, okay? And I've already shown you a bunch of super cool and useful DaVinci Resolve Studio features here on my channel, like the surface tracker, for example, which you can use to track stretchy and wavy things, like a t-shirt, and then you can put any logo you want on your t-shirt. Or analog damage that allows you to make your videos look like an old TV or VHS or a security camera. But the thing with those features is that even though they're super cool and useful, I don't use them that often, you know, only in very specific situations. And so that's why in this video, I want to show you some tools and features only available in DaVinci Resolve Studio that I use a lot more frequently. So some of my favorites, because, you know, those features for me really made it worth buying DaVinci Resolve Studio. And I want to share them with you. So, you all know that I love mood and atmosphere, right? Yeah, with fists and everything. And I always encourage you to get it right in camera, on location. But of course, sometimes that's not possible for small filmmakers and videographers and content creators like you and me, because we're alone and we have to improvise and adapt, overcome. And so, I really don't mind adding some extra atmosphere in post, some extra cinematicness. So, I often use the lens flares and lens reflections effect because it makes it super easy to add some extra atmosphere to a scene. And here's how it works. I'm sweating my ass off. Can you see it? I think if I stretch my arms now, you will see the sweat appear on my t-shirt. Should I try? Do I dare? You see that? It's hot here. I don't know if I should change my t-shirt now or not. Does this look really gross? Maybe I'll just change my t-shirt to a black one. So, in the effects library, look for the lens flares effect and also the lens reflections. Let's do the lens flare first. Drop it on a node and then you can use one of the presets or tweak and adjust to create your own custom flare. I think this looks nice, right? And now, if this was a static shot, we'd be done. But it's a moving shot. So let's track that movement. Go to the tracker here. And since we're tracking an effect, set this to effects. And then click here on this little arrow. Put that little cross on the object or the thing you want to track. In this case, it's the headlights. So I'm gonna track something close to the headlights. So I get the movement of the headlights, of course. And then hit track, and that's it. Now the effect, the lens flare, follows the movement of the headlights. And then the lens reflections effect is same but different. And I think I like it even more, because it gives your image, your video, a dreamy look. Something, I don't know. You know, the fists again. That, beautiful. So, yeah, there you go. The patch replacer tool, also known as the perfectionist tool, because you know, sometimes you just want the perfect shot, right? Especially when you manage to get the perfect composition, the perfect angle, and maybe you want to get, you know, like a minimalist look. But then there's that one little stupid thing in the frame that messes everything up, especially in here, in your head. And so, for your own sanity's sake, you need to get rid of it. See, I'm already like, yeah, perfectionist. And so, yeah, patch replacer to the rescue. It's a fast and easy way to remove objects, dust, spots from the frame. Basically things that you don't want. And here's how it works. So let's say you want to remove this thing here. Just drop the patch replacer on a node. And now in this circle, you'll see a copy of this circle. You know what I mean? So it copies this part. Now, again, if it's a static shot, you're done here. But if it's a moving shot, just like before, just like with the, what was it? With the lens flare, use the tracker to track the movement of the shot. And that's it. And you know what else perfectionists need? Perfect music. And coincidentally, or not, this video is sponsored by Audio, where I get my perfect music. I use Audio for my background music, travel videos, client work, everything. And you know what? Every time I need music for something, I discover a new favorite track. Just go to their website and check it out. It looks really nice, try out the filters or browse through the playlists and just listen to some music. Because, you know, there has to be a connection between you and the music you choose for your projects, right? So just listen to some of their music. And if you like it, well, you're probably gonna like it even more when I say that their Audio Pro subscription is 70% off the first year. Just use my link and code in the description. Not too shabby, right? And on top of all that, I'm just gonna mention it again because they deserve it. They're really nice people. So yeah, there you go. Thank you so much, Audio, for supporting my channel. Okay, and now back to DaVinci Resolve. Next is lens distortion, and I used this effect a lot back when I didn't have any anamorphic lenses. And, you know, I wanted to make my normal spherical lenses look like anamorphic lenses. Simple. So if you want the anamorphic look without an anamorphic lens, this one's for you. And it's just fun to play around with, you know, and create a cool look. And you don't have to make it too complicated. We're not trying to make our spherical lenses identical to an anamorphic lens, because that's pretty much impossible. But something in between also looks cool, in my opinion. So what we need is barrel distortion, because that's a characteristic of anamorphic lenses, next to the flares. But what we don't want is that my face and body looks weird, which is what you get when you use the lens correction tool, for example. See? It just like adds too much distortion in the middle. So instead I'm gonna use the lens distortion tool, because yeah, I want to add distortion and not correct it, if you know what I mean. And see how it doesn't mess with the center of the frame as much? I can add distortion, but it won't affect my face and body too much, if I don't overdo it, of course. And if your subject is not in the center of the frame, you can always move the center of the distortion effect to keep the subject looking normal. Just try to keep it balanced. Not too much, don't overdo it, balance. It's all about balance. And then we have Magic Mask, probably the most versatile tool in this list, because you can use it for color grading, effects, compositing, also text masking, you know? So, for example, let's put some text behind me. Now, there are two main types of Magic Mask, object and people, but you can actually use both on both people and objects. It just depends on the situation and what your image looks like, the contrast and the lighting and all those things. So if one doesn't get the result you want, just try the other one. Let's start with the object magic mask. Just draw a line over whatever you want to mask. Literally just a few seconds needed. It doesn't have to be super accurate. Then track, and that's basically it. DaVinci Resolve will do everything for you. And then of course you can refine the mask if you'd like. And now if I add an alpha output channel, it will basically remove the background. And so, if I put the original clip underneath, I can put text in between those two clips and it will look like there's text behind me. Super easy, super fast. So, that's the object magic mask. But the people magic mask has a few cool extra features. You can actually select what part of a person you want to mask. Body parts, clothing, you know, those things. Like my t-shirt, for example. See? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Remember when I showed you an editing trick that I use quite often, where I make a shot go out of focus to create an ending or a transition? Remember? No? That means you're not watching enough of my videos, actually. I suggest 3 a day, you know, to keep the doctor away. wow. Anyway, look, you might think now, but you can just blur your image in the free version of Resolve. And that's true. In the color page, or use an effect like Gaussian blur, which is available in the free version. And you'll definitely get a nice blur effect, but the lens blur effect takes your blur effect to the next level. So add a lens blur, and at first glance you might think, but yeah, it's blurred now, great. So what? Well, take a closer look at the bokeh. See? It will actually create a realistic looking bokeh. Bokeh, whatever. That has the shape of an aperture. And you can even change the shape of that aperture, depending on, you know, what lens you're supposedly using. So that's pretty cool. It just adds that little bit of extra je ne sais quoi. Again with the fists. I'm doing it too much. I'm sorry. And I'll add a bonus just for you. Aperture diffraction. It's actually one of those effects that goes in the list with halation and glow. You know, effects that I use a lot. But that's because I love the film look. Aperture diffraction allows you to get a similar effect, a stylized look, nice glowy highlights. And of course it's easy. Just drop it on a node and, well, there you go. You can see it right away, how the highlights get that nice glow. Again, just play around with the settings to create some, you know, customized looks. It looks great, it's easy and it's fast. I love it. Maybe a bit too much, I know, but what are you gonna do? But anyway, so that's it. The point of this video, what I wanna say with this video is that, you know, if you're getting a little bit more serious with your editing and your filmmaking, your videography, your content creation, you're definitely gonna love DaVinci Resolve Studio. And it's just a one-time fee, $295. That's it. You get more effects, hardware acceleration, more supported codecs, 10-bit, neural engine. What I showed you in this video is just the tip of the iceberg. And I'm definitely gonna make more videos on why DaVinci Resolve Studio is totally worth buying for content creators, videographers, filmmakers. Until then, thank you so much for watching. I'm literally dying right now. I'm like, you can't see it on this black t-shirt, but trust me, it's wet. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully see you in the next one. Oh my God. Just had a horrible, I can't remember if I pressed the record button on my audio recorder. Oh God, I'm gonna check.